It's not going to be easy.
There are two uncountable miracles.
The people who has a Bible here, a Bible. Somebody give me Bible. Bible, 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 Bible. Give me a Bible. Someone. This is a holy Bible. This is a holy Bible.
Mm.
The people that brought this Bible to us, white people, they did not explain it very well to us, Africans. Can I talk?
Talk, Baba.
Can I open your eyes?
Open them, Daddy.
You see this? This Bible. They didn't explain it to us. And the problem with African people is they jump too much. An African. Yo. I used to have children all around me, all over the world. I just teach them to say, get this, do as I say. Do it like this. Do it like this. Miracle will happen. Immediately that thing happens, they jump. They open a church. Africa, we didn't, the same way they brought Bible without explaining it to us, is the same way they brought democracy without explaining it to us. That is why we are praying even when we are not supposed to pray. How can a church have Sunday service, Monday service, Wednesday service, Friday service, if by mistake you are in protocol or in press team, there will be Saturday practice? What time do you have to wake? Am I talking?
I'm talking, Daddy.
What time do you have to wake? Sunday you are in church, you are praying. Monday you are in church, you are praying. So many people are losing marriage because of this rubbish. Listen, what are you praying for first? What do you want? Then, after that, there are even some churches that will have women service. What do you want to tell women that you didn't say on Sunday during the service? There is youth service. Come on. From Monday to Monday is church. Prayer. What are you praying for? What do you want? Every day you are in church. Every day you are praying. There is 21 days of fasting on prayer, commanding heaven. Are you telling me that you have to take 21 days to command heaven? On Sunday, you can't command heaven. 40 days of fasting and prayer. Are you Jesus?
Talk, Baba.
This is the problem in Africa. We didn't learn. The white people that brought Bible to us, this Bible you are talking about, they don't pray like this. I saw some people celebrating that you see, Donald Trump has declared the National Day of Prayer. Rubbish. Did you hear his statement before he declared National Day of Prayer? He said, number one, we'll have the best doctors. Physically, he's prepared. He said, number two, we have closed all the borders. Physically, he's prepared. He said, we have released $50 billion to fight corona. How much has your country released to fight corona? Before you talk about declaring National Day of Prayer for corona. The Bible made it clear, heaven help them that help themselves. If you don't help yourself, you are praying, you will die, you will be poor. Corona will meet you praying, it will kill you there. I'm telling you, you see white people, they are very clever. They didn't explain it to us. Bible is a good thing. Every day before I perform any miracle here, I preach from Bible. Every day. There is no Sunday that I come here, I don't quote scripture and preach. But Bible do not ask us to read the scripture. It says search the scripture. It means read it with brain. There is time for everything. There is time to pray. That is why today you see churches all over. Before this church, I think we're up to 7 churches here. Every classroom had a church. In all the whole country, every classroom must. If you go to a school, you can see there are 20 churches in one school. In Nigeria, it's worse. In one upstairs building like this, there can be 50 churches. This one is making noise. Yeah, this one is making noise. Yeah, this one is making noise. Woo, this one is making noise. Wow. They are praying every day. But take time to verify that the more we pray, the more our problem increases. Because we are praying without action. We are praying without working. Even if I marry you, even if you are my wife, and on Sunday, I allow you go to church. Monday, when you are supposed to stay with my children or go to work and find food, you go to church. What are you going there to do? The same thing you are going to pray. Why didn't you pray it on Sunday? People are even praying on Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday is everywhere. Midweek service. What are you praying for? That thing you want to ask, is it different from what you asked on Sunday? Why not pray on Sunday and use the rest of the day to look for food? To help yourself, because heaven helped them that helped them. Job! Listen. If you are looking for a job, you bring your CV and we'll pray for it on Sunday. On Monday, don't come back for prayer. Go and take it to the people that will employ you. Go and look for a job. Go and look for business. Stop praying. Africa, we overdo everything. Everything for us is shaking, mama. Rubbish. The more we pray, after praying, we go to people that are not praying to borrow money. We go to China and ask them for money. Because China know how to work. They don't know how to pray. Heaven does not help lazy people. This is why today, listen, many pastors, prophets, bishops, they are rich. Because of you. Can I talk?
Talk, brother.
Opening a church in Africa today is very simple. Just fail your grade 12 examination or matric. Make sure that you fail it. Once you fail it, open a Facebook page and start going live on Facebook. Change your name. Put Prophet Sia 1, Prophet Isaiah 2, Bulldozer 1. Put it and start speaking on Facebook. People will follow you. I'm telling you. It's easy to open a church. Make sure you fail your exam. Once you fail your matric, you're automatically a prophet. That is it. That is what is happening. Many of you that on Facebook, we know that I'm not the only one suffering. When I want to go and read news on Facebook, immediately I log in my account. The news feed is filled with prophets. This one is prophesy. That one is ta-ta-ta-ta. I even fear to log on Facebook now because everywhere is prayer. And because it's easy, you just get a school. Some of us, to open a church, we had to go to this immigration, that. It took time for us to open this church and have a certificate. But in all this school, you will see. So long as you know you have failed your exam and nobody's there, you have told your parents, Jesus has called me. You start going live on Facebook. Start preaching on Facebook. Church has started. And that's why everybody's preaching rubbish. That's why people, that way they are surviving. That's why they can say there is 21 days of prayer. And you, as Christians, you leave your work. Instead of going to look for job, going to look for business, you leave your work. You come and sit down. On Sunday, I will preach. On Tuesday, I will preach. On Monday, I will preach. Remember that if I declare 21 days prayer and fasting here, it's your offering times 21. Am I talking?
You're talking, brother.
If you are giving one rand every Sunday, and I declare 21 day service, you are giving 21 rand. Pastors are surviving with brain. Pastors that depend on offering. Once they open it, that's why you can see there is this service, there is this service, there is this service. The more you come, the more you give them money. They use it to buy pizza and eat, but you have not eaten. They use it to buy suit and wear, and you don't have wear. What are you talking about? What is going on? Africa, when are you going to wake up? How many times has China prayed? Why is China very blessed? How about India? Buddhist country, a country that don't believe in Jesus. When our politicians fell sick, yeah, they go to India to heal themselves. They go to unbelievers. They have the best medical facilities. How about Dubai? Pastors will collect your offering after 21 days of prayer and go and eat it in Dubai. Give it to unbelievers that don't know Jesus. When will you wake up as Africans? When you see somebody like Siawan that is performing miracle, that one I suspect is his power because he does not pray too much. What do you mean by he does not pray too much? God himself had to work for 6 days and rested on the seventh day. And he said, this day that I've rested is a Sabbath day. Keep it holy. He worked with his hand. He created with his hand. Even when he was making Eve, he did not prophesy. He did not pray. He took ribs from Adam and started molding it. He used his hand and molded it, and it became. If God can work, what are you praying? God has heard your prayer. You must go out and look for job. You must go out and look for business. You must go. There is, Ecclesiastes said there is time for everything. Before President Trump declared the National Day of Prayer, he already took care of everything physically. He has already prevented. Wait, very soon you will hear our African countries like Zambia, today we want to pray against corona. When they are praying there, they are transmitting corona among each other. And that's why the Bible says, my people perish because of lack. Heaven will not help you until you start helping yourself. It is time for you to stand up. Take a step. Take a step. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
Take a step. When you take a step, God will do the rest. Clap your hand for Jesus.